Some of you have heard of the term blood-brain barrier, and of course some have not, but let's just say you basically have a brick wall around your brain. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Your body is constantly in flux from eating, drinking, exercise, whatever. Amino acids and hormones and other chemicals in your body change in response. For example, your blood sugar spikes after you eat a delicious piece of cake. But there's one area that you'd want to remain relatively unchanged, your brain. So there's like a fortress between the brain and the blood called the blood-brain barrier, or BBB. So what is this thing? Shout out to Asmin LaCroix on Twitter for asking us this very question. Hashtag AskDNews. The BBB surrounds blood vessels in the brain and central nervous system. It locks down the brain and spinal cord fluid. It lets the necessary molecules through and keeps the bad stuff out. It's made up of tightly knitted endothelial cells, enzymes, and transporters. Some people have described it as a brick wall around a vast majority of your brain, where each cell in the blood-brain barrier is a brick, and the tight junctions between them are the mortar. The BBB allows small molecules like alcohol to squeeze through, and the enzymes and transporters allow essential nutrients like vitamin C and omega-3s to cross. But large molecules and bacteria are kept out. This whole system keeps what's on the inside stable. And the brain needs specific microenvironments to function properly. The brain's communication system relies on chemical and electrical signaling between neurons in a tightly controlled environment to function. But conditions like inflammation and HIV can weaken the barrier. If a bacteria or virus in the bloodstream were to bypass the barrier and get into the brain, it would get into the way of that kind of signaling and things would get thrown way out of balance. And brain infections are incredibly rare thanks to the BBB, but that also means when someone does get one, it's incredibly dangerous and hard to treat. While good at keeping out the bad stuff, the BBB is unfortunately good at keeping out the good stuff too, like potentially life-saving medicine. According to the Royal Chemistry Society, over 95% of drugs do not show any useful activity in the brain. Those that do make their way into the brain are only for conditions like depression, schizophrenia, and insomnia. There are ways to bypass the barrier, but it's complicated and is basically neurosurgery, like an intracerebral implantation, which just like it sounds, is an implant put directly into the cerebrum. But brain tissue is dense, so it's hard for medicines to diffuse through the tissue, so it's not ideal. But there might be a way to tunnel through the brick wall with sound waves, which could help brain tumor patients. Brain tumors are notoriously hard to treat or take out with surgery, especially a nasty one like a glioma. They often leave roots behind, and chemotherapy can't cross the barrier, leaving few options for treatment. So researchers at Sunnybrook Health Sciences Center in Canada did something no one else has done before. They opened up the barrier with sound waves to let chemo in. Seriously, earlier research published in the journal Ultrasound in Medicine and Biology found that tiny air bubbles injected into the bloodstream could open up the BBB enough to let the good stuff in. They used low-intensity ultrasound waves to guide the bubbles to blood vessels near the BBB. These sound waves made the bubbles expand and contract and kind of vibrate. This vibration jiggled open some of the junctions between cells in the barrier. In the case of the Sunnybrook research, once openings in the barrier were made, life-saving chemotherapy could slip through and finally reach its target. So our bodies are complicated and weird and mostly fighting for us, but sometimes we have to work against it to save lives. Speaking of weird body things and blood things, ever wonder why we have different blood types? Julian has the answer in this episode right here.
They're describing little surface markers on the blood cells called antibody generators, or antigens for short. Antigens come in a lot of different varieties, and your body's immune system attacks cells with antigens that don't match your own.
So do you have any other questions about how the body works? Let us know down in the comments below or find us on Facebook or on Twitter, and don't forget to use the hashtag AskDNews.